across the Atlantic Ocean in less than 4 days by ship is an experience no ancient mariner could have conceived, but one the modern traveler achieves in the greatest security and comfort, with no more effort than packing a suitcase or a trunk. The 4 pleasure-filled days slip by all too quickly aboard the Queen of the Seas. Days pass with recreation or in leisure. In the veritable floating city, the speed is not noticed except against the side of the gliding vessel or to the rear in the mighty ship's wake. The first glimpse of France is Le Havre, home port of transatlantic French ships and continental starting point for so many whose European journeys are either annual vacations or fulfillment of lifetime desires. The huge ship, largest and fastest liner ever constructed, glides majestically into the harbor of the great port and beautiful city. A port through which so many millions pass, but in which so few linger. On the North Dyke, thousands gather to watch the coming of the giant vessel, an occasion which never ceases to be the favorite of so many who live in this second seaport of France. Le Havre, at the mouth of the River Seine, was founded in 1509 by Louis XII and fortified 6 years later by Francis I as a base for his unsuccessful assaults upon England. Today, it is the chief harbor of the northern coast and, after Marseille, the most important of all France. Around the semaphore of the North Jetty and along the Chaussée des États-Unis, a promenade, many come to watch the arrival and departure of vessels from all parts of the world. The port consists of 2 outer and 11 inner harbors, well protected by breakwaters and tide gates. Southampton Quay, where channel steamers and small vessels dock, is that quay at which the first British soldiers of the World War landed on August 7, 1914. The Basin of Commerce, one of the 11 inner harbors, penetrates the city as far as the Place Gambetta. In the neat square is an imposing monument by Poisson to the heroic World War dead of the city. Small sailing craft and other pleasure craft tie up to quays or moor in the Basin of Commerce, in water that is clear and clean enough for bathing. So many transatlantic travelers pass through Le Havre without realizing it is one of the cleanest and prettiest of cities, with improved waterfronts, beautiful parks, splendid thoroughfares, and fine buildings. The Exchange, the Bourse, is but one of the many handsome structures in the city. The new railroad station at the end of the Boulevard de Strasbourg. The tree-lined avenue, which leads from the station to the sea, is one of Le Havre's loveliest. The Rue Thiers, another principal thoroughfare, connects with the main roads to Paris. To beautify the city, flower containers have been attached to lampposts. The Rue de Paris, the principal shopping street, runs from the Southampton Quay to the City Hall Public Garden, a park typical of all French parks, where the plants and flowers are constantly changed and carefully tended, remaining in continual bloom from early spring until late fall. A statue of François Premier, who developed Le Havre, is in the center of the garden. Facing the park is the City Hall, called in French Hôtel de Ville. The Boulevard Strasbourg passes the City Hall and continues to the sea as the Boulevard Foch, in memory of the Commander-in-Chief of the World War Allied Armies. At the end stands the monument erected by the Belgians in gratitude for the help given by France during the World War, when the seat of the Belgian government was temporarily located at Le Havre. Another famous landmark of the city is the curious Sugarloaf Memorial, which stands on the hill at Sainte-Adresse, a suburb from which can be had a splendid panorama of the city and the mouth of the Seine, and a vantage point from which to watch the arrival and departure of ships. North of Le Havre, along the shores of the English Channel, are numerous resorts and watering places. One of the most fashionable is Etretat, an old Norman fishing town. The ancient market building attracts many artists who find subjects in its timbers and in numerous other structures dating back hundreds of years. Etretat is a favorite rendezvous for English and also many continental summer visitors who come to enjoy the bracing climate and the splendid sea bathing of the Norman coast. Etretat, situated in a sheltered valley at the foot of lofty cliffs, has a superb beach that looks out upon a small bay where the action of the sea has worn away the cliffs, cutting caves and arches in them and forming curious needle-like projections. On the Falaise d'Amont, one of the cliffs overlooking the beach, is a small chapel of Notre Dame de la Garde, and to its rear an imposing white monument in memory of the intrepid World War flying aces, Nungesser and Colley, first to attempt an Atlantic airplane flight from Europe to America.